Konnichiwa Marbotakus, I'm the Gimme Otaku, and welcome to Assault Rifle Parts for Noobs, where I will give tips on how to identify the Borderlands 2 Assault Rifle parts and the stats that each part provides. Now in my sniper parts video, I said snipers were the hardest parts to identify, but in terms of remembering the given stats, I would say assault rifle parts are the hardest. And if learning assault rifle parts doesn't strike your fancy, then feel free to check out the Weapon Parts for Noobs playlist. But with all that being said, let's jump right in. So if you're gonna learn gun parts, the quickest way is to know the unique styles that each manufacturer uses when creating their parts. However, the manufacturers that we will be covering are the ones that create assault rifle parts, which are Vladov, Bandit, Dahl, Jacobs, and Torg. Vladov is the hardest style to explain, but basically with their parts, they'll have multiple of the same piece. And we'll get more into that once we start identifying parts. Bandit is made up of a bunch of scrap metal stitched together. Dahl is a lot more refined and looks similar to actual gun parts we would see today. Jacobs is like Dahl, but more comparable to older gun parts in the real world. And Torg is big, obnoxious parts that just screams in your face. To begin this ride of craziness, we will be going over barrels. Unlike other gun types, there's no bonus to having a matching barrel to the gun's manufacturer. So let's start with the most annoying part first, which is the fact that there are two Vladov barrels. Starting with the one with two slightly exposed barrels, with the longer one being on the bottom, this increases fire rate and mag size, but decreases recoil reduction and accuracy. And then the one with multiple barrels, which is more of Vladov style, this increases fire rate, mag size, and recoil reduction, but decreases accuracy, and this barrel provides higher bonuses and penalties than the other Vladov barrel. Moving on to Bandit, this increases damage but decreases accuracy, and this barrel has two slightly exposed barrels as well, however the longer one is going to be on top. Then a Dahl barrel provides faster recoil recovery, increased recoil reduction and accuracy, and decreased damage. And this barrel is just very rectangular. A Jacobs barrel increases damage and accuracy, but decreases recoil reduction and fire rate, and is going to be sticking out from the top of a metal plate. Next is the Torg barrel, which increases weapon damage and mag size, but decreases recoil reduction, reload speed, and fire rate. And this is just a big, bulky, round barrel. And this is where things are going to get really confusing again. Because a Torg barrel will act differently depending on the manufacturer of the gun it's attached to. A Torg barrel on a Vladov gun will fire small, fast-moving, high damaging rockets at a medium rate of fire and consumes 2 ammo per shot. A Torg barrel on a Bandit gun fires slow, high damaging rockets at a slow rate of fire and consumes 3 ammo a shot. A Torg barrel on a Torg gun fires extremely high damaging rockets at a very slow rate of fire and consumes 4 ammo per shot. A Torg barrel on a Dahl gun fires high damaging grenades that detonate after 3 seconds or upon contact at a slow rate of fire and consumes 3 ammo per shot. And finally, a Torg barrel on a Jacobs gun fires high damaging grenades that detonate after ricocheting off a surface or upon enemy contact and consume 2 ammo per shot. Moving on to grips, if the grip matches the gun manufacturer, then the gun gains additional reload speed and mag size. We will start with the Vladov grip, which provides slower recoil recovery, increased fire rate, and decreased damage. And this looks like a stiff, slanted grip with a lip slanting downwards. A Dahl grip provides faster recoil recovery, increased recoil reduction, and decreased damage. And, just like the Vladov grip, is a slanted grip. However, the lip on this one will be slanted upward instead of downward. Then a Bandit grip increases mag size but decreases reload speed and accuracy, and looks almost like a wannabe Hyperion grip with a little nub right here. A Jacobs grip increases damage but decreases recoil reduction, reload speed, and fire rate, and is very curved, looking like your typical old-timey rifle grip. And then to finish, a Torg grip increases damage but decreases reload speed, recoil reduction, and accuracy. And this grip looks very metallic with 3 screws here and a lip at the bottom. So moving on to stocks, just like the barrels, there will be no stat bonuses for having a matching stock. So starting with the Vladov stock, this provides faster recoil recovery and decreased recoil reduction, and will have 2 rods branching from the top and bottom of the gun to the back of the stock. A Bandit stock does nothing to the gun and will have 2 beams connected to what I can only describe as a 3-fingered claw. A Dahl stock increases accuracy and recoil reduction and provides faster recoil recovery and can be identified as somewhat triangular with this hole in the middle. A Jacobs stock increases accuracy but decreases recoil reduction and slows recoil recovery and is very bland and slanted downwards. And then to finish, a toric stock increases recoil reduction but slows recoil recovery and is very bulky with what looks like padding on the back. For sights, just like the other videos, we will be identifying them by how they look when you aim down sights. Sights do not provide any stat changes other than your field of view when aiming down sights, and there is a chance you won't get one. So to start, a Vladov sight will look like a circle with the top cut off and a rectangle in the middle. A toric sight will look like what I can only describe as a house awning. A bandit sight will be a rectangle with round sides. A doll sight will be a trapezoid with round sides. And a Jacob sight will be a circle with the top and bottom cut off. Then, to end the parts, we have accessories and prefixes. These two go hand in hand since the prefix is decided by what accessory you have. Keep note that there is a chance you won't get an accessory, however, legendaries and uniques can still have a prefix without the accessory. They will just be determined by the gun's other characteristics. Starting with the blade at the tip of the gun's barrel, this will provide increased melee damage and comes with the knifed, breech, razor, stabbing, and skewering prefixes. Then for the box on the side of the gun, this increases fire rate and bullet speed and comes with the fast bullets, deep, cowboy, slipper, and swift prefixes. For the secondary grip, this provides faster recoil recovery and increased recoil reduction and comes with the tactical, patrol, horse, rhythmic, and resolute prefixes. The flat metal piece that is located on top of the stock increases mag size and comes with the expandified, onslaught, flush, plump, and expansive prefixes. And then the accessory that's rounder at the top but also located on top of the stock. This increases accuracy and comes with the accurate, scout, deadshot, rigorous, and severe prefixes. Now for the final two accessories, just like the three shotgun accessories, they look exactly the same. They are both flashlights on the side of the gun, and the only way to tell them apart is by the prefix being provided. So if you have nasty, attack, boss, nasty, or ferocious as a prefix, then the accessory increases damage but decreases fire rate and recoil reduction. But if you have wild ass, feral, wild, or rabid as a prefix, then the accessory increases damage and fire rate, but decreases accuracy. Now, I only mentioned four prefixes for that last one because that accessory comes with the wild prefix on both a Jacobs and a Tor gun. As I said in the beginning of the video, assault rifle parts are difficult, but hopefully I explained things as clear as possible. And with that, we're done with assault rifle parts. Hopefully I made things clear and there isn't any confusion. If you have learned the assault rifle parts due to this video or still have any questions, feel free to comment down below. Also, leave a like and subscribe if you're not already for more gaming otaku content. And with that, I will see you all in RPG Parts for Noobs. See ya!